Today, we're going to go through a couple of ways to record great sounding vocals to add to your tracks. Getting your vocal recording right is really important when recording a song. Firstly, it's important that the listener can hear and understand the lyrics in order to convey the feeling and emotional meaning of the song, but also because we as humans are used to hearing voices every day, so it's easy for us to tell when something doesn't sound quite right with the delivery of a vocal. As with any recording, there's no right or wrong way to record vocals. It depends entirely on what you're trying to achieve. If you want to create a shouty megaphone effect on the vocal throughout the song, then you should probably just ignore everything I'm about to say and go and buy a megaphone and record that. Absolutely nothing wrong with that. But today we'll go through a more common technique for recording vocals, which will enable you to achieve a clear and professional result from home. This tutorial aims to give you a good starting point to further experiment with the sound if you want. But first, make sure you don't miss out on future tutorials and videos by subscribing to the EVO channel. So let's start by picking a microphone. The two main microphone types for recording vocals are dynamic and condenser mics. Condenser mics typically capture more detail, especially in the higher frequencies, which means that the vocal can potentially be captured more accurately. However, dynamic mics are often a favorite for slightly louder and often shoutier vocals, which might be a little bit too loud for a condenser. If you haven't got a vocal mic yet, then getting a large diaphragm condenser is probably the best bet for flexibility. However, if you already have something like a trusty Shure SM58 or anything else, just give it a go and see what it sounds like. For this example, we have the EVO SR1 microphone plugged into our EVO 4 audio interface. All condenser mics require phantom power in order to perform correctly. So we switch it on by selecting the channel the mic is plugged into and then pressing the 48 volt button. But before we do that, we need to work out the actual placement of the vocalist. To begin with, we'll go for a standard close vocal sound. So place the mic about 6 inches in front of the singer's mouth. A useful trick is to get them to spread out their hands and put it in front of their face. This gives you a rough idea for distance. If we were to record them singing right now, we run the risk of plosives ruining the recording. Or in other words, the P's and B's causing rushes of air into the microphone and making a horrible wind-like sound.
We keep making plans, but they crumble like sand 'cause we let them.
So to fix this, we'll set up a pop filter in front of the mic. If you don't have one of these, your best bet is just to place the microphone at a slight angle to the singer so they aren't singing directly into the microphone. So with the pop filter in place, this should give a nice balanced sound, and you can change the sound by moving the mic closer or further away from the singer. If you have a directional mic like the EVO SR1, meaning it picks up sound from certain directions rather than all the directions, moving closer to the mic will introduce the proximity effect, which basically just means the closer you get, the bassier it gets. This can be useful to experiment with depending on the sound you want. So if you want a rich vocal sound, then make use of this and put your singer closer to the microphone. Or if the vocal's meant to be a bit more of an up in the air backing vocal, then move them further away.
We keep making plans, but they crumble like sand 'cause we let them.
Another thing to look out for here is sibilance, which is the sound that S's make. Depending on your positioning, these can come through quite harsh and often quite piercing. There are a couple of ways to fix this. Firstly, you can just record it and use a de-esser in software. However, if you want to fix it at the source, you can just angle the mic slightly away from the singer's mouth so it isn't direct.
I don't understand how this happened so fast, but I guess that's just life.
So 6 inches in front of the mic with a pop shield, keeping an eye on sibilance and the proximity effect to shape your sound. However, there are two other key things to consider when recording vocals. One is the room you're recording in. So as well as trying to minimize any background noise spilling into your recording, the shape and size of the room can have a massive effect on the sound. It's definitely worth looking into some basic acoustic treatment if you can. Worst case scenario, you can hang up some heavy blankets or duvets behind and to the sides of the singer to create a kind of makeshift vocal booth to minimize any reflections getting into the microphone. Finally, you can't record good vocals without a good vocalist. So make sure the singer is warmed up and well practiced in what they're singing. And also keep in mind that a vocalist who understands the effects of the distance from the mic and the angle of the mic to their mouth, and even how their breathing affects the recording, will only be beneficial to your recordings. So give them a hand if they're unsure. Now we can set levels using EVO 4's Smart Gain by pressing the Smart Gain button, selecting channel 1, and then pressing the Smart Gain button again. Now we need the singer to sing the loudest part of the song, and after a few seconds, Smart Gain will set the perfect level. Of course, you can still set the gain manually if you'd rather spend longer doing boring technical tasks instead of getting on with recording music, but hey, what do I know? But if you're setting gain manually, aim to set it so the meters in your audio software are peaking at around minus 10 dB. This allows enough headroom in case the singer decides to sing a bit louder. So now you're ready to record.
We keep making plans, but they crumble like sand, 'cause we let them every time. I don't understand how this happened so fast, but I guess that's just life.
So this method is by no means the way to record vocals. It honestly depends on what you're trying to achieve. So have a play with mic types if you have access to different mics, put them in strange places and angles, record in unconventional rooms like a tiled bathroom, and just have fun with it. If you have a favorite vocal recording technique or have any weird places that you've recorded vocals, then let us know in the comments. It'd be great to see what people get up to. Don't forget to subscribe for more audio-related tutorials and like this video if you found it interesting.